A good night's sleep can help improve your learning, memory, decision-making, and even creativity. That said, having insufficient sleep or low-quality sleep has been linked to a higher risk of developing conditions such as heart disease, diabetes, and even obesity. And based on the current global population, there are over 230 million people that have some degree of insomnia. In this video, I wanted to share with you five of the best supplements you can take to help with your sleep. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. The first thing I wanted to note is that supplements may not always be the first option you jump into. Sleep hygiene is huge, and this should be actually the first place you look at. Some examples are things like falling asleep to white noise, a weighted blanket that is 10% of your body weight, avoiding caffeine 8 to 10 hours before bedtime, and that includes tea as well as dark chocolate, believe it or not, and limiting daytime naps. These are only a few things you could do to start off with. Then there are more things like avoiding blue light 30 minutes before sleep, sometimes longer depending on the person, and having a temperature of 60 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit when getting into bed. Sometimes doing these things alone can fix your sleep. Also, fixing the underlying conditions that can cause sleeplessness are key here too. Some of these can be your blood sugar, having GERD or heartburn, arthritis, and thyroid dysfunction are only a few to name. Fix these, and you might fix your sleep along the way. After that, what's the first supplement on the list? The first is magnesium L threonate. This study actually showed us that MAG threonate improves sleep quality via regulating brain electrochemical activity. And this is because it can cross the blood-brain barrier. A dose of 300 to 500 milligrams 30 to 60 minutes before bed should do the trick. I like the one by Momentus and Huberman Lab, which is NSF certified, that you could check down below in the description. Not sponsored by any of these companies, but listed below will be my affiliate links should you choose to go with any of them. You can find them in the description below. And if that doesn't work, or let's say you wanted to add on something else, the next supplement on the list is Passionflower. In this double-blind randomized placebo-controlled trial, the study demonstrated the positive effects of passionflower on objective sleep parameters, including total sleep time on polysomnography in adults with insomnia disorder. And because of the research, you find it now made into pills, capsules, dried herb, tablets, powder, liquid tinctures, and even shampoo. If it's your first time, try using the liquid tincture, 1 to 2 mLs 3 times a day in a smaller amount of water. And you could do this right before bed. Maybe it would actually be best if you already use it while you're in bed. You could go with the one by Horbach that is lab tested and alcohol free. Keep in mind, passionflower is also known to lower anxiety too, which doing so can actually help you fall asleep better. The third supplement is L-theanine, which I've already talked about in great detail in this video that I encourage you to watch after this one. In the study titled In Search of a Safe Natural Sleep Aid, most sleep inducers are sedatives and are often associated with addiction and other side effects. I'm sure you know which ones I'm talking about. L-theanine promotes relaxation without drowsiness, which is huge. Unlike conventional sleep inducers, L-theanine is not a sedative but promotes good quality of sleep through anxiolysis, probably because it increases GABA, serotonin, and dopamine. My favorite one is the 200 milligram one by Thorne because it's NSF certified, meeting the strongest requirements, and they do 4 rounds of testing for each product. Take this one 30 to 60 minutes before bed as well. The fourth supplement is glycine, which may help you fall asleep faster. It also helps to increase blood flow to extremities and can even cool you down. This study on glycine showed us that 3 grams of glycine improved subjective sleep quality and sleep efficacy and shortened polysomnography latency both to sleep onset and to slow wave sleep without changes in the sleep architecture. And this is the interesting part. Glycine lessened daytime sleepiness, which you often will find that problem with melatonin, and improved performance of memory recognition tasks, which is huge. Thorne has a 1 gram one that you can start off with and slowly increase it over time to 3 grams. And again, 30 to 60 minutes before bed. And lastly, the fifth supplement, which is L-tryptophan. In the systematic review, meta-analysis, and meta-regression of 18 articles, tryptophan supplementation, especially at 1 gram or more, can help improve sleep quality. But keep in mind, this might be better studied in milder insomnia cases. Both tryptophan and 5-HTP are serotonin precursors, right? Meaning they increase serotonin production, which as we all know is a neurotransmitter that supports a healthy mood. But 5-HTP is the version of tryptophan before it has been fully transformed into serotonin, meaning it may have a milder effect. I put this last on the list because if you're currently taking an SSRI, it may be better to avoid it or speak with your doctor first before taking it because of the risk of serotonin syndrome with this one in particular. But if you're in the clear to take it, then the one by NutriCost at 500 milligrams is not a bad one, as it also contains bioperine, which can help with absorption. Take this one 30 minutes before bed. And when you wake up, this is a powerful tip that is often underestimated that I want you to take out of this video. View the sunlight by going outside within 30 to 60 minutes of waking up. Don't necessarily look at the sun directly. What you want to do is see the morning light for about 10 minutes and then do that again in the late afternoon, just right before sunset. So instead of checking your phone right when you wake up, check out the sunlight first. This can do wonders for your circadian clock.